Good evening. This is a CNN Camp News Network special report. We bring you breaking news on a worldwide pandemic currently spreading throughout the greater Houston area. Officials call it the Purple Pandemic, appropriately termed due to a victim's incessant desire for purpling. Thus far, researchers have not been able to find a viable cure for this purple pandemic. We now bring you to Derek Lee, who has the latest.
Thank you, Jeremy. Recently, a new disease is crossing the nation, known as the Purple Pandemic. This disease has no known cure and is also more deadly than the H1N1 virus, which is known to cause swine flu. Today, we invite an expert named Dr. Kaka of the Houston Chinese Church Medical Research Team to answer some of our questions.
Dr. Kaka is a self-taught, self-licensed medical researcher who has been an expert in the area of pathology for the past 48 hours.
What is the purple pandemic? Well, the purple pandemic is caused by propalis viriditis. It is also known as the purple virus. It is a mutated virus of the Postcamp pardon virus, which is characterized by lethargy and excessive sweating of the eyeball. However, the purple virus is much more deadlier and much more delicate. The symptoms include darting eyes, they shift and they look around, diminished cognitive and mental abilities, and continued desire to impress the opposite sex through serenading, gift giving, and basically any other means necessary. It is highly contagious. The World Health Organization has placed it as a critical disease to treat. It has surpassed that of the swine flu. Like I said, it's highly contagious. It is transmitted through airborne, waterborne, droplet-borne, atomic-borne, Jason-borne, and basically any other borne necessary. You get it through touching, feeling, hearing, smelling, looking, even through Facebook. This is something we have never dealt with before. This is something very new to us.
To better understand the seriousness of the disease, we captured an infected camper with a Pokeball. His name is Shelby.
Ah, where's my girl? Where's my symbol? Amy, where are you? Andrea! Phil, save me! Ah!
As you can see, after 2 weeks of infection, his condition is only worsening. Next, we were fortunate enough to find this camp counselor, Daniel Lin, in a corner at Borders weeping over the tragedy of the purple pandemic spreading across camp.
Can you describe to me your account of purpling at camp? Man, it was horrendous. Girls chasing guys chasing guys. Man, it was chaos. I lost in my entire small group. All of my guys died from estrogen overdose. Can you believe that? Who's gonna clean up my cabin now? Do you remember how it started? It all started with Jody. Her shorts were 2 inches above the knee. I've even worn shorts that short. But man, Jody wore those, it was GG, game over.
Our research team is doing all it can to find a cure and a vaccine to prevent the spread of this disease. In the meantime, precautions should be taken such as involuntary separation between the opposite genders, you know, getting them as far apart as they can. And health officials are advising people to stay home, not go out, not having any human contacts, and instead just playing video games, you know, study for the SAT, something like that. And basically any other means involving solitary confinement.
As you can see, this purple pandemic is spreading quickly and officials are at a loss of what to do. However, as we speak, researchers and leaders from HCC, WHCC, CLCC, and CBC are planning to meet on August 14th for the Postcamp rally in order to devise a cure and a solution to this most deadly disease. Back to you, Jeremy.
Thank you, Derek, and thank you for watching this CNN special report. We'll keep you updated on the latest development on the purple pandemic. Up next, after the break, local Hillsong advocator Stanley Chang pushes Congress to pass a bill that mandates the wearing of modesty pants. Stay tuned.